I don't need them. I don't need any of them. So that first piece, cantoned by Giovanni Gabrieli, he was a Baroque composer, lived in Venice, and worked at St. Mark's Basilica, where there were balconies on the side, and he wrote a lot of pieces like that, that are polychoral. So they're different choirs of instruments that play at different times. Can you hear me okay? Okay.
The light went on, Tor.
Hello? Thank you, Torg. How about this?
Okay. So the next piece we'll do is a motet by Bruckner. It was originally written for voices, three trombones, and cello and string bass. And this version you'll hear is arranged for brass choir. And for those of you live streaming in, you just have to watch me because the performers are up in the balcony. Oh, yeah. So we'll reset the stage a little for a few minutes, and then we'll invite the choirs up for Bruckner's Requiem. Okay, I'll enjoy the spotlight then. So, when we decided to do Bruckner's Requiem, several faculty members came up and other musicians just said, are you doing the whole thing? Because Bruckner is known to be long-winded. He wrote 9 symphonies and most of them are well over an hour long. But this particular piece, he also calls for gigantic forces. This particular piece is on a much smaller scale. The whole piece under a half an hour, and some of the movements just very, very brief. But we decided to do it, and it's been a wonderful adventure for us. So we'll invite Dr. Corrine Duffy to conduct.
Since we just performed for you, I know it was a great first half, wasn't it? Since we just performed for you the Mass for the Dead, which is what a Requiem is, the second half is all lighter music. The first piece we'll play by Joseph Bologne. Bologne was a classical composer, a little younger than Haydn, a little older than Mozart, who came from a French colony in the Caribbean. And his father, a wealthy French landowner, and his mother, one of the landowner's slaves. He moved to Paris, was educated, became an orchestra leader, a conductor, a head of an all-black cavalry union in the Napoleonic Wars, a champion fencer, just an incredible person, and will now play his first symphony. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
So we'll close our concert with Moldau by Czech composer Bedrick Smetana. Smetana wrote a collection of 6 tone poems all about his homeland, was later the Czech Republic. And this particular one called the Moldau is about a river through the Czech Republic. And it's just one continuous movement, but you'll hear different areas of it. We begin with the headwaters, and then the river grows, and then the river goes past a wedding dance, and then eventually at night at a calmer section, it goes through rapids. It's just a delightful tone poem. So hope you enjoy Smetana's The Moldau.